I am tempted to say there was war between the ANC and the DA. Helen Zille attacked the ANC and then demanded that Panyaza Lesufi be brought and be disciplined. And the ANC summoned Mr. Panyaza Lesufi to Luthuli House. And Mr. Panyaza Lesufi says, I was never born a coward.
Oh, I'm tempted to say that, hey, Gubi, paya ku ANC, my dot. I've got letters that I'm about to read, but hey, it appears like onga pants nonga pezulu. Hey, my dot.
Hwa, Panyaza Lesufi, hwa, Helen Zille, hwa, Panyaza Lesufi, hwa, Helen Zille, hwa, Fikile Mbalula, hwa, hey. He, my daughter, you, sir, fatin.
Oh, my daughter. I'm not sure. Take a look at what he said. Here.
Ah, we are one of our two, Mvumeni Helen. We are shy, ipolitiki yakhe. We are one, she's achieving to divide the ANC. Engaqali. Lento kaPanyaza, is not something new for Helen. And her strategy to divide the ANC and rule this country. And if the ANC mayinganakile, izogcina kuPanyaza engathi uPanyaza obhedayo, besikhohlwa ukuthi there is someone behind these divisions. I remember mina ngoba ngangikhona ngekhathi ethize, how we were assisting the ANC we divide ngama motion okhipha umsholozi. Ngangikhona phela, ngikhuluma into engiyazi. EDA, there was always underground work eyayenziwa nabantu abathize within the ANC to divide the ANC, and even these terms of RETs and how RETs were becoming an enemy of the country, yonke le yayenziwa behind the scenes. So namanje ke ayiyalapho manje. ANC of late ukuthi hayi ugogo uyayishaya into yakhe uyaba divider futhi uyabona njengamanje uyaqeda ngabo slowly uyaqeda ngabo kuzoba nzima kakhulu.
Okay, in the midst of everything, you know what I'm saying, all this back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, you know what, there's a letter that was written by EDA. Look, the letter is very, look, in fact, they wrote two letters. And then there's another letter that comes from the ANC, right? So let's start with the one, the one that is coming from a DA. The Democratic Alliance wrote a letter and say, DA will now withdraw from these talks. The ANC must accept the responsibility for the ongoing chronic instability in these metros and continue saving service delivery failure as South Africans approach the 2026 local government elections. Selous Brink as the executive mayor of Tshwane is non-negotiable condition for this talks to resume. The ANC should take careful note of the widespread of anger and backlash in the capital city against parties responsible for removing Mayor Brink. The mayor blunder of yesterday's event can reserve by re-electing Brink to the position. So in other words, they are saying bring him back to the position, and the only time you and I have a conversation, it is when he is back to the position. But wait, this is more than that. Then they said, it is very unfortunate that substantial progress we have made has been undone by the operancy of your Gauteng leadership under Premier Panyaza Lesufi. Sorry, until the ANC national leadership reassets its authority in Gauteng, metros in our most popular province will continue to disintegrate with a profoundly negative economic consequences. So what I'm hearing and what I'm seeing here, the DA basically, they are saying, The problem that we have here is none other than Mr. Panyaza Lesufi. He, any instability can be blamed to none other than Mr. Panyaza Lesufi. Do you agree or you disagree with this notion? I don't know where you stand with this notion, but wait a minute. You know what? I want us to take this journey together, but before we can successfully take off and elaborate and bring these two letters together, I will only require you to do this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people, because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 Rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel. And you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Okay, so now let's proceed again. The ANC, remember that they are saying, the DA is basically saying that Panyaza Lesufi the ANC must deal with Panyaza Lesufi, right? The question that you have to ask is, will the DA accept, or I mean, will the ANC abide by the DA's position? Remember, it has been said by the ANC that Panyaza Lesufi explained the GNU well. You think I'm joking? Well, Ufikile Mbalula was addressing the media, and Ufikile Mbalula speaking about Panyaza Lesufi, I want to remind you categorically here, and I want to be clear, before I read you the letter, what should I do? Let me read the letter first and then place the video. You will listen to Panyaza, look, you listen to Ufikile Mbalula and then look at the, look, and then listen to the letter, what is it saying? Ufikile Mbalula, look, I'm sorry, the ANC, they, look, on the 7th of October, released this letter, and this is what it says. Request to meet with the national officials on 7th of October 2024, that is Ufikile Mbalula. I have observed with concern your public utterances with regards to the matter pertaining to the GNU and the coalition in local municipalities following the national and provincial elections. These public utterances that you have made clearly go against the resolution made by the National Executive Committee. You will recall that the NEC elaborately discuss the aftermath of the unfavorable election outcome, which henceforth has characterized a significant strategic setback, and that mindful of the pitfall of the previous options that unveiled, the NEC ultimately resolved on the GNU and the on the GNU as most viable option. In contrast, your public articulation seems to argue in contradiction to the NEC resolution in this regard, thereby bringing the ANC into public disrepute. Ordinarily, an organization that fails to observe the basic tenet of organization with respect to the principle of democratic centralism and naturally invite such public dispute and ridicule its leadership. You are accordingly requested to present an explanation to the national official on why your public utterances should not be considered to be only in violation of the principle of democratic centralism, but that is inevitably violate the ANC constitution with the consideration that all the NEC decisions are binding to all lower structure. You are therefore requested to make this presentation as outlined above tomorrow, Monday, the 7th of October 2024, at the Chief Luthuli House, 10th floor at 10 o'clock. Right? So they didn't understand his utterances about the GNU. That very same Fikile Mbalula had this to say.
And I've seen Sizwe Mpofu Walsh releasing a podcast video where Panyaza explained excellently GNU. I like it. Go and watch it. So that's a very excellent explanation about the GNU. And that is what is expected of a leader of the ANC in the province. Populism that is perpetrated by others, not Panyaza, by others, that for the ANC to be in the GNU, it's a sellout position, is populism. And it's ideologically inadequate. They are lazy to think. You will know that a tactical intervention is not equal to a strategic goal, because GNU is not a strategic goal. It's temporary.
So I don't understand. There's something that I don't understand, right? I'm a man born under sin, subject to correction. I'm trying to understand what is actually going on here. It can't be that the ANC, they are saying this whilst we're waiting, whilst we're listening to this, then the ANC says that, right? It can't be that the ANC is telling us that he has done nothing. But then when you listen to the ANC says he has done something. What is actually going on? What is what? And who is telling the truth? That is what I'm basically confused. When it comes to that, I'm like, wait a minute. Am I confused? Didn't I understand Mr. Mbaks as of saying that the man was clear? What is happening here? Are you pressured by EDA? Are you pressured by the interpretation given by EDA? Are you pressured by... what's going on? I'm trying to breathe. Because it's difficult to breathe under these circumstances. Eh? We are trying to understand who is in charge here. Is it the ANC or Helen Zille? Who is in charge of the actual ANC? Remember the words of Helen Zille when he says that when the dust has settled, people will realize that their battle is between the DA and the EFF. Obviously, the formation of MK Party created that as well. So with that being said, I'm interested to know from you, what has been your observation? See you on the next episode.